The Unity team has made a lot of ridiculous decisions over the years, but none of them are as retarded as their decision to put preservation of your eyesight behind a $40 per month paywall. In their own words, you must upgrade to Plus, Pro, or Enterprise to enable the Easy on the Eyes environment, implying that the free edition is intentionally designed to strain your eyes as an incentive to upgrade. So for educational purposes and in the interest of preserving the eyesight of developers from around the globe, I'll show you a universal way to patch any version of Unity from Unity 5 to Unity 2020 and beyond. Now, while there are a lot of tutorials on how to enable dark theme already, they either come with pre-made patterns to find the right location to patch, which then don't work on new versions of Unity, or they require complex tools like low-level debuggers. But in this video, I'll show you how to do it for any version using just the hex editor. I'll be showing it on Unity 2019.2 here, but I'll also show it on Unity 2020 and Unity 5.5 as well. It's all the same process, but I'll show it three times for good measure. Now, of course, you'll need a hex editor, and if you don't have one already, there are plenty of free ones. The most popular is Hext, which you can easily find on Google. Next, you'll need to find your Unity installation, typically on the C drive in C Program Files Unity Editor for the 64-bit version. For the 32-bit version, it'll be in Program Files x86. Now, the theme to use in the editor is controlled by a function in the Unity software, which returns an index of the theme to use, where index 0 is a light theme and index 1 is a dark theme. This function normally returns a chosen theme if you're using plus or greater, or 0 if you're using the personal edition. So we need to patch this function to always return 1. Now, normally this is not as trivial as it is for Unity, as software typically don't have any names associated with memory addresses. Fortunately, Unity is massive and used by thousands of developers, so it ships with a PDB file, a program database containing debug symbols used for debugging. We'll use this file to locate the function in the executable and then patch the function. Start by opening the PDB file in the hex editor, then hit Ctrl plus F to open the search dialog. Type get skin ID X, which stands for index, and hit OK. We'll want the one with an at symbol after the name, so hit F3 till you find this. We then need to get the offset of this function, which are these 4 bytes here. They'll be the 4 bytes after the byte with a value of 2, followed by 3 0 bytes. Make sure your hex editor displays values in hex, and then copy the offset. You'll want the unsigned 32-bit representation, also known as uint32. If your hex editor doesn't show various representations of the bytes like this, you can get the same number by reversing the order of the bytes and then putting them together. Note, use the values from your version. If you copy the values I have, you'll get the wrong location. We now have the offset in the clipboard and can close the PDB file. Next, we'll need to modify the Unity executable, but most likely Windows won't allow you to do so as it's in a protected folder. So drag unity.exe to the desktop, hold the Control key to switch from moving to copying, and then open the copy in the hex editor. Now, this is not a tutorial on the portable executable format used in Windows, but just know that they're divided into various sections, and we can find the configurations of these sections by scrolling down a little bit till we find names like text, rdata, data, pdata, etc. Now, what these are for and why they're named this way is outside the scope of this tutorial. However, we need the offset of the text section, as the offset we copied from the PDB is relative to the text section, and the offset of that section is right here. Now, don't copy this offset, as that'll overwrite the one we found in the PDB. Just hit Ctrl G to bring up the Go to Offset dialog. Then type 400 and make sure hex and begin are selected, then hit OK. This brings us to the beginning of the text section, which is typically where code resides. Now hit Ctrl G again and paste the offset from the PDB into the box, again making sure hex is selected, but this time make sure we go to the offset relative to the current offset, then hit OK. So we are now at the offset of the text section plus the offset of the function inside the text section, which is the absolute offset of set function. A couple hundred of the bytes at this offset is the actual machine code of this function, which we'll completely replace with our own. But with what? Well, these are the raw machine instructions read directly by the processor, which aren't very human-friendly. Fortunately, they are available in a human-readable version known as Assembly. Now, instead of having to download all sorts of tools, there is a website where we can assemble and disassemble these instructions. So open your browser and go to diffuse.ca, then go to the disassembler. Here we can write instructions for the processor. Of course, this is not an assembly tutorial, so don't expect to write your next program in assembly after watching this. Anyways, the processor contains various internal registers, and the one called EAX is used for 32-bit return values, which is what we want. So we'll just write a couple of instructions here to set this register to 1 and then return to the caller. This sets the EAX register to 0, this increases it to 1, AL is an 8-bit register overlapping the lower 8 bits of the EAX register, so increasing this by 1 will increase EAX by 1. This is just a more optimized instruction than if we increased EAX. Finally, the RET instruction tells the processor to return to whatever code called this function and continue execution from there. That's it. Make sure to tick x64 and then hit assemble. And here is the machine code that we need. So copy these bytes, switch to the hex editor and make sure you're still at the correct offset, and then paste with overwrite. And that is all. Save the file, then copy it back into the editor folder and launch it. And there you go. Now, as I said in the beginning, I'll be showing the process again for Unity 2020 and Unity 5.5 just for good measure. So once again, find the Unity editor folder, drag the unity.exe file onto the desktop, remember to hold Ctrl to copy instead of move, then open the PDB file in the hex editor, press Ctrl F to open the search dialog, type get skin IDX, actually just append the at symbol to the end as well so we find it immediately. Then trace backwards till you find the byte with a value of 2 followed by 3 0 bytes, the 4 bytes after that are the offset. Turn on hex display, copy the unsigned 32-bit integer offset, close the PDB, open unity.exe from the desktop in the hex editor, scroll down to find the sections. Now, I didn't actually explain this before, but the way to find the section offset is to select 20 bytes from the section name, which is actually .text. So select from the dot right before text, then 20 bytes forward, which is 14 hex. The 4 bytes after that will be the section offset, and once again, that is 400 hex. Remember to not copy it so you don't overwrite the PDP offset. Then hit Ctrl G to open the Go to Offset dialog, enter 400, select hex and begin, hit OK, hit Ctrl G, paste the offset from the PDB, select hex and relative to current offset and hit OK. So there's the code of the function. Go to diffuse.ca, write the code, remember to tick x64, hit assemble, copy the bytes and paste with overwrite in the hex editor, save, copy unity.exe to the editor folder and launch. And there we go. Now I'll just show it again for Unity 5.4 actually, the 32-bit version actually, to show that the process is exactly the same. So, locate Unity, copy unity.exe to desktop, open PDB, search for get skin IDX at, locate the byte with a value of 2 followed by 3 0 bytes, the next 4 bytes is the offset, display as hex and copy, close the PDB and open unity.exe in the hex editor, find the .text section, or skip it because it's probably always 400 hex for Unity, select from the .text and 20 bytes ahead, 4 bytes after that is the offset, don't copy, hit Ctrl G, type 400 hex, begin, OK, Ctrl G, paste from PDB, hex, current offset, OK, go to diffuse.ca, write good code, make sure x86 is ticked and hit assemble. Actually, the code is identical for 32 and 64-bit in this particular case, but don't want to get into the habit of forgetting this when it actually matters. Copy bytes, paste overwrite, save, drag into editor folder, launch, and profit! Just a note, the code will always be the same bytes, so you don't actually need to assemble every single time. You can store the bytes somewhere. Anyways, that is it. Enjoy your eyes, and bye-bye.